Bienvenidos al Medical Spanish Podcast. Soy la doctora Molly Martin. Through this podcast, we provide interactive audio lessons for learning practical Spanish for healthcare and elsewhere. The level of this lesson is beginner, but should serve as a great vocabulary review for all. Timestamps are provided in your show notes. Hola a todos. Today, I have another lesson from the Review of Systems module in our History and Exam course. I am updating all these lessons with the help of Luis Almeida de Venezuela. If you'd like to sign up for our course covering a complete history and exam in Spanish, there's a link in your show notes. I hope you find these lessons helpful. In this lesson, we will practice various neurological symptoms in Spanish using an audio flashcard format. I will say each term or phrase in English. During the pause, it's your turn to interpret this term or phrase in Spanish before Luis does. Then, I recommend you repeat the term or phrase after Luis, attempting to replicate his pronunciation. ¿Listos? Empecemos. First, we'll cover symptoms related to headaches. Headache.
El dolor de cabeza.
Severe headache.
La jaqueca.
Migraine.
La migraña.
And
la jaqueca
can also be used to say migraine. Neck stiffness.
La rigidez en el cuello.
Rigidez is a useful word when speaking of stiffness in the muscles and joints. ¿Ha notado rigidez muscular? Changes in vision.
Los cambios en la vista.
O
los cambios en la visión.
Now let's cover symptoms related to sensation. Feeling or sensitivity.
La sensibilidad.
So when referring to a sensation, we use la sensación. But when referring to the ability to feel or sensitivity, we use la sensibilidad. Do you have feeling in your arm? ¿Tiene sensibilidad en el brazo? Light sensitivity.
La sensibilidad a la luz.
Numbness.
El adormecimiento.
O
el entumecimiento.
Numb.
Adormecido. Adormecida.
O
entumecido. Entumecida.
So whenever we introduce an adjective, Luis will say it in both its feminine and masculine forms.
Adormecido, adormecida, entumecido, entumecida.
And don't forget, when referring to someone who is non-binary, you use the ending e. So to say numb, you would use adormecide or entumecide. Tingling.
El hormigueo.
And this comes from the word for ant, hormiga,
tingling.
El hormigueo.
Now let's cover symptoms related to unsteadiness or dizziness.
Balance problems.
Los problemas de equilibrio.
Unstable.
Inestable.
The adjective for unstable in Spanish is gender neutral.
Inestable.
Vertigo.
El vértigo.
Dizziness.
Los mareos.
O
el mareo.
Dizzy.
Mareado. Mareada.
Symptoms of weakness or fatigue.
Weakness.
La debilidad.
Weak.
Débil.
So the adjective for weak in Spanish is neutral and does not change based on gender.
Débil.
Fatigue.
La fatiga.
O
el cansancio.
Sleepiness or drowsiness.
El sueño.
O
la somnolencia.
And how do you think you would say drowsy?
Somnoliento. Somnolienta.
Symptoms related to impaired cognition.
Hallucinations.
Las alucinaciones.
Confusion.
La confusión.
Confused.
Confundido. Confundida.
Difficulty remembering things.
La dificultad para recordar cosas.
Phrases and symptoms related to head trauma.
Blow to the head.
El golpe en la cabeza.
To hit one's head.
Golpearse la cabeza.
And when speaking of accidents or injuries, such as breaking a leg or hitting your head, we use the pronominal form of the verb, romperse la pierna, golpearse la cabeza. He broke his leg. Se rompió la pierna. Ooh, I hit my head. Me golpeé la cabeza.
To lose consciousness.
Perder el conocimiento.
O
perder la conciencia.
To faint.
Desmayarse.
And this is a pronominal verb.
Desmayarse.
I faint. Me desmayo.
Concussion.
La conmoción cerebral.
O
la contusión cerebral.
And we also use the word contusión to refer to bruises or contusions in other parts of the body. Por ejemplo, sufrió una contusión en el muslo. Symptoms related to seizures.
Seizure.
El ataque.
And if you're just introducing the topic, it's best to be more specific and say,
el ataque convulsivo.
You can also use
las convulsiones
to refer to seizures.
Las convulsiones.
Gloria, my teacher from Mexico, recommends using convulsiones in its plural form, that it may sound weird to ask someone, ¿ha tenido alguna vez una convulsión?
To Gloria, this sounds like we're asking about one convulsion of the body, rather than a series of convulsions which make up a seizure. In this case, Gloria suggested, ¿ha tenido alguna vez convulsiones? That being said, my teachers outside of Mexico have told me that using una convulsión to refer to a seizure is perfectly fine.
To convulse or seize.
Convulsionar.
Muscular spasms.
Los espasmos musculares.
Repetitive movements.
Los movimientos repetitivos.
Involuntary movements.
Los movimientos involuntarios.
To stare into space or to stare blankly.
Estar con la mirada perdida.
Tremor.
El temblor.
To shake or tremble.
Temblar.
To lose bladder control.
Perder el control de la vejiga.
To lose bowel control.
Perder el control intestinal.
O
perder el control de los intestinos.
to bite one's tongue.
Morderse la lengua.
So when we perform an action on ourselves, we use the pronominal verb, in this case, morderse, followed by the body part, la lengua. How do you say, I wash my hands? Me lavo las manos.
To bite one's tongue.
Morderse la lengua.
Bien hecho. Espero que te haya sido de utilidad esta lección. In the next member lesson, we'll practice using all these terms and phrases in questions. To learn more with us and support the podcast, click the link in your show notes to become a member and access all our lessons and courses at DocMolly.com. Members get access to our premium Medical Spanish podcast feed and to our collection of over 400 Medical Spanish lessons with full lesson notes and downloadable PDFs. Members at DocMolly.com also get access to our courses, which provide an organized curriculum where you can track your progress and use Quizlet sets to reinforce what you learn. Or, if you just want to hear the latest 3 months of member lessons, you can subscribe through Apple Podcasts. You may have noticed I don't run ads on the podcast or at DocMolly.com. I want to keep us focused on learning medical Spanish. Therefore, I rely on member support to keep this project going. If you're not a member yet and you find this podcast helpful, please consider becoming a member. Gracias de todo corazón y hasta la próxima. This is a production of DocMolly.com, where we learn practical Spanish for healthcare and elsewhere.